It's a weird name from the one who not born and raised in Israel, so it's Or Ofer. And I'm the CEO and founder of SimilarWeb. SimilarWeb is a 200 employees company today, $65 million in funding and growing. Another 100 employees on the way, maybe some of them in the crowd. And I'm gonna start with a little bit with questions to understand where to take my conversation. So I assuming a lot of the people, almost everyone is Yahoo employees, am I right? Everybody work in Yahoo? Raise your hand. Oh. Oh, so now then. Half. Interesting. Okay, so, and how many of the people here are from this special program of the product manager in Yahoo? Raise your hand. Okay, so guys, check them out. Go speak with them. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about the product and the product iteration and the path our company went from 8 years ago to where we are today. So what is SimilarWeb? Today, SimilarWeb is the leading measurement, I think, company of the digital world. What we do, we basically measure every app and website, and we provide insight, a better version of Alexa, if people here know what is Alexa. And to demonstrate a nice quick demo, and take, for example, this is a free website we have, everybody can go, put any website or app, and basically you get some nice stat. And this is example about information you can get about Airbnb, so you can see rank 699 in the world, 330 in United States, number 3 in travel and accommodation, and some other nice stuff you can get. Oh, nothing you can get. Oh, this is very interesting. Let's see. Maybe it will work out now. Oh, now we can get. So you can see, basically very nice to see how many visits this website have, the engagement, page views per user. So in Airbnb, you can see 27 million visits on desktop, 10 minutes every user spend on the website. They're doing 12 page views. Most of the traffic come from the United States. And then, of course, you can understand how the traffic arrives. So a lot of it's direct, very strong brand. Then you can see very nicely which website are pushing traffic to Airbnb, and after it's arrived to Airbnb, where it's live. And another nice example, search. So you can see what people is searching in order to get to Airbnb, organic, paid, for which social network is get this traffic from, where it's advertised. Oh. I'm very bad in Mac on a PC, sorry. I know people hate me for that, but it's not my strongest point. So let me tell you a little bit how basically we're able to do this magic, because it's very unique, okay, to get the data. We basically seeing everything going on in the digital world. So the way we collect our data and able to reach this amazing statistic about every website is combination of 4 different data sources. The first one is a panel. Basically, we have the biggest panel in the world of devices that we're able to see their online activity, mobile and desktops. It's 100 million devices. It's a very big sample. We take this data and then combine it with ISP data. ISP, Internet Service Provider, basically we have agreement with a lot of operators around the world. It can be, you know, ISP can be T-Mobile, can be Orange, can be Verizon. So we sit on the pipe that's shifting the internet around the world, analyze it, combine it with a panel, and then combine it with a third data source that is called crawling and scraping. So basically we crawl all the website and the apps, analyze them, understand them, and also then do scraping, basically to emulate users to understand all the data. We combine those two three data sources, building model every day how the digital world behave. Then we're able to verify how accurate our data is with something we call the learning set. It's direct measurement. SimilarWeb in the past 3 years become very standard in the digital world for measurement. So a lot of companies come and give us direct access to their data because they don't want us to downestimate them. Because they want to attract advertisers, they want to attract investors. So they give us access to the real data. So we have hundreds of thousands of websites and apps with the real data. So this enable us basically to check and verify how accurate we are, and it's iteration that all the time going and improving ourselves. This is a free website, everybody can go, come, check, so just finish with a small thing to show you. For example, I can click here and I can see all the leading, who are the biggest travel accommodation website in the world, and I can filter it by country, so see Booking number one, Agoda number two, Airbnb is number three. So it's very nice, and attract millions of users using us, basically to understand how the digital world behave, measurements, see themselves, compare themselves. So the way we monetize, we have a much more advanced system, it's called SimilarWeb Pro, that is like market intelligence. It's a crazy system, I can go and show you, but it's gonna kill the whole day. But basically you can put any website, any app, see all their secrets, it's really that crazy. And we have the same thing for mobile, that it's also very interesting. You can put any app, can see how many installs it have, the engagement, so think how amazing it is, you can understand exactly the trends of all the apps, etc. Now, what I'm going to tell you today is our journey to get to this point, because we are 8 years company and it took us a while to get to the place that we can predict the digital world. And it's a funny story. And the story began 8 years ago, similar, when we tried to build a recommendation engine for website. Okay? And let's see if I can find. Oh no, why Mac? Why? Why like this? Oh! So this, all the Mac behave like that? Or it's only when I touch them? Oh. So, yes. So eight. It's my touch. So 8 years ago, we basically start build a technology that running and mapping all the website in the internet, understand them, and basically recommend you other website. If you like CNN, we're gonna tell you if you like CNN, try BBC, New York Times, etc. The idea was to build. Ah, it's Google, yeah, of course. Stos Google. So we try to build, we build a recommendation engine that every website you find basically give you other examples. We launch a browser plugin and we called it SimilarWeb. This is what's our name. So this browser plugin become very popular. People love it. We got millions of users downloading it. It's been compared to StumbleUpon. I don't know if people you know that. And back then we've been featured, but you need to remove the slash when you search. Oh, yeah, it's working. So, giggle, but it's her, it's not me. It's not landing page, it's image, it's on Google. So the nice story that we started as a browser plugin, we didn't able to monetize it. Okay, we had the amazing idea to put sponsor ad among our recommended website. And if I'm able to open it, I can show it was very nice. And the business model didn't work, but they got millions of users. And part of improving the technology, which website we should recommend, this is a good example, yeah. So this was our first browser plugin. Look how nice, you had a sidebar, and basically every website you check, it was give you other recommendation which website you should check. So it was very nice, it was huge. We put feature on Firefox. Back then there was only Firefox browser, there was not Chrome. So being featured on Firefox, it was like being featured on Apple Play Store, so we got millions of users. So part of the technology to improve which website to present here, we basically started to collect user surfing behaviors in order to improve the technology. Because if we saw in millions of users moving from BBC, then going to CNN, etc. We understand that if you like CNN, we should show you BBC as a recommendation. And we call this algorithm also visited. People who visit this website also like to visit this website. And we start collecting all this information. And when we got to like 4, 5, 6 million users, we got amazing amount of data of user behaviors on the online. So research companies that deal with analyzing the digital world start approaching us, tell us, we were happy to buy this data from you. We're doing research on the internet. So we were happy, we found a business model. So we start getting more data in order to licensing the data. So we start building more product to the browser that more people download them. And then we grew up a product offering and got to 10, hundreds of different products. People were downloading and we basically collect the data. And then in 2011, we decided that we are going to do the shift from a command of similar site to basically going to web measurement. So we took another 2 years to basically develop this very tough technology and to understand and analyze this amount of data. And in 2013, we pivoted SimilarWeb to a web measurement company. So it took us a while, and we had to move few iteration of product. And maybe I'm going to show you another, if you can open a tab, new tab. It's Control T still working. And on the way, I'll show you some few. I used to do a lecture about life cycle of idea. So we start with a browser plugin. I didn't tell you on the way we open a website called similarsites.com that become also huge. So it basically work the same technology of website recommendation, but not as a browser plugin, but as a website. So basically you can come, you can put IMDB, any website, and basically getting all the other similar sites to it. And this website, when we build, also become very big. It got to 1.2 10 million uniques every month, people coming and checking recommendation. If you like one website, how you can check. So I think the nice story, you know, we start with a browser plugin. Then we shift to websites, start building some website. And in the end, we find ourselves measuring the whole digital world. So this was my short version of 8 years of how we're able to get to that. And I'm going to leave you now a few minutes also to ask some questions if you have. Yes, of course. It's a good question, very smart one, and I tell you why. Because I almost 3 years of my life was sitting to define what is similar. Because, and it's not a simple question, because when we start to recommend websites and you come to bring similar sites, so similar sites are different, so one can be same family. For example, Google and YouTube are similar. No, it's same family. And then you have competitor, Google and Yahoo. The competitor. And then you have added value, like stuff that if people who use Google also use CNN, okay? Because they like to go to see news. So they have to choose, if you people get, for example, checking Google, what other similar site you recommend them to. It's gonna be search other search engine, or it will be other from same family, like Gmail, YouTube, or it will be complementary product. So the idea and the concept we built that make the technology back then, even still today, to be very good, that we decide to do a statistic model. Basically, it took all those engine. It took all the results that come from same family or all the competitor, mix them into 20 results. Then user used to click. Okay, and the results, and we understand which one is more popular, and we let them in some point to vote if they like or don't like. And then we took this machine learning to understand for each website if it's going to be good or bad. Because, for example, in google.com, one of the similar site was Google CoIL. So it was very interesting, and we put a lot of time how to solve that, and in the end we found that the user solving, so it was very similar to search engine. When search engine show you result, a lot of it from the clicks helping you to align the result. So it's a good question, and it took us a while to nail that back then.
How do you get data from the ISP? Most of the data today is encrypted. Is there any source?
Also a very good question. So it's true. ISP data become less and less valuable because of the HTTPS, but hackers like us from the Israeli army, they take it and love that, can manipulate the HTTPS to understand the domain.
You're using only the client as the client
alone, or? Sorry?
You're using only the client as
I'm not in the R&D anymore. In similar, when we did similar site, I used to be hands-on. I don't do hands-on in the next, but I can redirect you to the right guy in the company to ask. Okay, so it's also a good question. So we have an amazing team, one of the best team in Israel for data science, only PhD, and like you are second degree.
Say,
No. Startup like us. Yeah, I was a big. No, we have amazing team, best one. I'm not gonna argue with you now.
Ah,
okay. So talk with me. I will explain you why. So our team basically build the rules because we have the learning center to understand how much. First, you start with the size. So our thumb rule is you need 1% of the online population in order to predict well. So if you want to predict the United States, we need at least two. In the United States is 200 million online users. So we need at least 2 million people in our panel. Then you need to make sure it's diversifying. Diversifying means it's different browsers. Okay, if we have IE, Firefox, and Chrome, according to the distribution of them, and then different users. And different users mean you need active, advanced users, they're doing like 100, 200 page views per day, and you need less advanced users, they're doing 50 page views per day. And then we're able to understand, and also when we predict the website, we can understand where we have bias. For example, we think that in the vertical of shopping in the United States, the data is not that great, so maybe we should work harder to get all more users. But the system always know to fix the graph and to understand, or we need more users or different users. But we're taking the statistical model that more people you have, the better the data. So instead of having 2 million, we're putting 10 million. So we always make sure that we have enough people. So how we get them is the way we started. We started with building very high quality product that people love and download. And this is the approach we took over the 8 years to basically we build the skills to maintain a panel. So we always building more nice product or acquiring. So today the company is quite big and doing a lot of money. So we're also acquiring other products in this division in order to have more and more offering to get more and more users. In the mobile, it's even easier because we have app, we have weather app, solitaire, etc. Yes, Yael. Oh, nice.
One of the things for the big companies, we are extremely careful not to lose the trust of the user because they don't want us to spy on them. There are always big scandals about that. So, and it can be super creepy. So big companies, we have to do that. Don't you have any legal issues, privacy issues?
Also a good question, of course. What? The question was about privacy, because basically you collect data stream. So the nice thing that we took as approach from the day we start, that we don't collect PII. I don't know nothing about our users, and all our database, we save data all about websites, all about apps. This is the entities we have in the database. And what happened, and when you don't deal with user data, you have no privacy because the website doesn't have privacy and apps doesn't have privacy. And the product we distribute, we are very, very clear that once you download the product, you're joining a global panel that helps predict the internet. It's double verified that they need to agree. If everyone understands 100%, I'm not sure. But if you take other product out there like Gmail, you get Gmail for free. In return, you read all your email and sell your advertise and understand what you do, read your emails. Facebook do the same. So you cannot compare. We are the most less privacy concerned company in the world, I think, because we don't deal with users. Yes? The business model. We don't like to do money. Non-profit organization. No, I'm joking. I started to talk in the beginning. So we have three business model. The first and the very big one, we have advanced system that I told you, it's called SimilarWeb Pro. It's really crazy system. Yahoo is also a customer. Google is a customer. Facebook is a customer. eBay is a customer. Every big company in the online world is among our customers because it's like a dashboard that you can see everything going on in the digital world. Think how crazy it is. Every company out there need want to see our data. If it's the CEO from the product to the marketing department to build it, or from the business analyst to everyone. So Google, for example, have like 30, 40 accounts that just to get to use our system. So this is one part, is basically a SaaS platform that people are paying to get use. And we have an API, so companies want to integrate our data about the market into their system. And we also have some data partnerships that people want to understand the data. For example, hedge fund predict the stock market with our data. Think how crazy, I can see if eBay performs better or worse, if Netflix have more subscribers, if Twitter apps go up or down. So they use us in building model to predict the stock market. So it's another business model. And we're doing really great. If you're gonna, I think that we are the fastest growing startup by employees and revenues in the past 2 years in Israel. So yeah, it's nice. Oh, they want to kick me up. Last question? No question. Guys, thank you so much. And enjoy Israel.